If we want to unlock the secret behind the origin of our sun and its planets, it would be helpful to find some remnants from the birth itself. An event that took place about 4.5 billion years ago, when, for reasons not yet known, a cloud of gas and dust transformed into a sun with circling planets. Luckily, there are some rocks left over from our earliest days. Asteroids, formed during our solar system's birth. Occasionally, some of them drop in on Earth. And when they do, they're called meteorites. So can these space rocks tell us what triggered the event? Here at Arizona State's Center for Meteorite Studies, its director, Minnie Wadwa,
come on in,
is trying to decipher our cosmic past.
Here you will gown up to go into the clean lab.
Inside, Wadwa breaks down meteorites in search of their chemical birth certificate. After crushing and dissolving them in acid, she can identify the atoms and molecules inside. The results? This meteorite is laced with a special kind of atom called nickel-60.
Nickel-60 is interesting for us because it is the decay product, the daughter of iron-60. And iron-60 is really what we're after.
Nickel-60 is created when another atom, iron-60, decays through radioactivity. So when this rock formed, it was originally infused with iron-60. And iron-60 is created in only one place, a supernova. The violent, destructive explosion that marks the death of a massive star. So that means when these meteorites were forming from a gas cloud during the birth of our solar system, 4.5 billion years ago, the gas cloud had been sprinkled with iron-60 from an exploding supernova.
The one question that we're trying to understand right now is, could such a supernova actually have been involved in the formation of our own solar system?
Alan Boss is one astrophysicist convinced that we owe our existence to a supernova. He thinks it happened like this. Like everything else in the universe, we started out as a cloud of gas and dust. Then, a distant massive star died and went supernova, sending a shockwave toward us. When the wave of pressure hit the cloud, it collapsed and condensed, starting a chain of events that led to the formation of our sun. You can think of it kind of like a snowplow. As the plow pushes through a parking lot of light, fluffy snow, the snow clumps together in bigger chunks.
You can create mounds of snow or destroy them.
We can do either or.
So you are the supernova of the ski slope.
That's for sure.
Out in space, pressure hitting a gas cloud has a similar effect. Except, instead of snowballs, you get stars. Once you've got the makings of a star, gravity draws leftover gas and dust into a giant swirling disk. The dust continues to stick together, clumping into rocky asteroids, which eventually become orbiting rocky planets. And voila, a solar system. But wait a minute. A supernova is one of the most powerful explosions in the universe. It's so luminous, it can be seen across billions of light years. It releases as much energy in an instant as our sun will produce over its 10 billion year lifetime. So how could a baby solar system survive such a violent, destructive event? Well, not everybody's buying the supernova as a creator theory.
What remains a little bit controversial about that idea is that you can't have that fluffy cloud near the supernova. When that shockwave is just coming out of the supernova explosion, it's super strong.
For Steve Desch, a supernova hitting a gas cloud is more likely to do this. Like a snowplow in overdrive, A supernova shockwave might sweep away any gas clouds in its path. Desch thinks something gentler triggered the collapse. A shock driven by radiation from a massive star. We still don't know for sure what the trigger was. But since we've discovered meteorites with supernova dust, we do know that a violent explosion rocked our cosmic neighborhood at the time of our birth. And it's quite possible that without it, our stable, stately solar system would never exist at all.